Hey, they're dynamite, man. I spent my last $11 to come see these guys tonight. And I got it, Evita. That's the 1960s national anthem. I grew up on that.
The fans even included Playboy model Vicky LaMotta, ex-wife of former boxing champ Jake LaMotta.
I can feel her butterfly.
According to Billboard magazine Music Research, the Enigata De Vita album had a staggering run on the charts, 2 years in and out of the top 10, and verified the claim that Iron Butterfly was the first rock act ever to receive a platinum record. Longtime band members Lee Dorman and El Rhino.
Well, it's still selling. It's still selling. We still get those quarterly BMI checks. Mm-hmm.
Fly on to Jamaica.
But what about the current tour and the show's content?
About 5 or 10% of it is some fairly recent stuff, but it's straight ahead rock and roll, blues oriented, and the rest of it is really just an updated version of the old hits. We do a 90-minute show, and it's all retro rock.
With Iron Butterfly in Miami, Corey James.
Most young musicians, but 20 years ago it became a nightmare for a couple of San Diegans. They were with a psychedelic rock group called Iron Butterfly. And tonight, in the first part of his special series, Whitney Southwick introduces us to bass player Jerry Penrod.
You know, Paul, when Jerry Penrod graduated from Claremont High, his ambition was to play football, not rock music.
San Francisco was where it was happening in the 60s. Mecca, if you were a rock musician. The lyrics told of free love and drugs. And more often than not, those singing the songs practiced what they preached.
You had all the money, the women, the booze, the drugs. I mean, you wanted it. I mean, it was just all there. You know, everybody wanted this. 20 years ago, yeah, it was living. That was life. And that was a good life.
For Jerry, the good life lasted only a short time. He quit Iron Butterfly before Enigata De Vita brought it national attention. He kicked around with a couple of other groups, then finally, burned out and addicted to drugs, he called it quits and returned home to San Diego. Two bad marriages and a drug rehab program later, Jerry today is back on his feet and for the past 10 years has driven a bus for the city of San Diego.
Love it. Love it. It's really a good job. A lot of people, you know, you have a lot of interaction with a lot of different people and you can make people smile.
You probably know people who take to work home with them at night. Well, Jerry does too, but in a very special way. He goes from driving a bus to living in one.
It's nice. It's fun. You know, I bought it a couple years ago, and just, you know, it's like, it's my big boat, and I can go where I want. I can move when I want, you know.
And today, Jerry moves in a much different direction than 20 years ago. His nickname, The Bear, more for appearance than personality. As for music, well, he still picks up his guitar now and then, but says he'll never return to the stage.
The life's just frantic. You know, too fast. You just about got to do drugs. It's always there. And it's just, it's fast. And it's hard, hard life.
What's important to Jerry Penrod today?
Be the best I can be. Being happy. That's important to me now.
San Francisco was the center of the American music scene. Psychedelic rock was in. A San Diego group, Iron Butterfly, was on its way to the top, but for some of its members, the trip proved to be too much. Tonight, in the second part of his special report, Whitney Southwick talks with former lead singer Daryl Deloach. Is it Deloach? Okay, to find out why he quit his dream come true job with the band.
Stay away from people made of plastic in a mold.
It was great. It was fantastic. It's everything I ever wanted to do and be. I love singing. I love singing. I absolutely love singing.
Iron Butterfly was a dream come true for Daryl Deloach, and for a couple of years, life could not have been better.
That was the happiest times of my life, really. I must tell you that. I mean, I've never been happier than being on stage and singing with the boys and stuff.
Dissension in the band ended the dream after only one album. Daryl left the Butterfly, tried a few other groups, then finally called it quits.
It was nuts. In the 60s, it was absolutely nuts. It was such a rebellious time. There was a lot of LSD. There was a lot of drugs. Everybody did a lot of things. And I just had to get out of it. There came one time, one day, when I said, I can't be here anymore. It was just too fast.
Back home in San Diego, Daryl turned to his second love, cooking. He opened a couple of restaurants and today earns a living as a waiter. Still in his heart, there has always been the music.
Being in front of people, I enjoyed people, you know, and, you know, making them laugh, any kind of attention. I love attention. Anything I could do to get a strip. I've always wanted to get back up and try it again. Not maybe just do the whole thing again, but try it and see if I like it.
Now, the band that Daryl is singing with is the local group, the Sears Brothers. Daryl joins in when he is not working in a restaurant. As for Iron Butterfly, well, the group is still around, played one of the local swap meets about a year ago, and in fact just finished up a Midwest tour, and all that background music in both pieces was from their first album, Heavy.
Now listen, I want everybody that doesn't belong in this dressing room to get the hell out of it, and right now.
This is my family.
Out. You don't belong back here.
This is my
family. You too,
Brunhilde.
Let's go. Out. Come on, girl. Get in here. Out. There's your party after the show, not now. The band doesn't listen to me for 2 seconds.
Oh, nice big one says something to me sometimes.
Sure.
Smells like jock straps in here, y'all. Danny.
Yeah.
Let me see the list.
Here.
Let's cut Fire Down Below.
Oh, come on. What was you always like that one?
Well, let's cut. Keep on rocking then.
Rose, the set's all right.
No, it damn well is not.
Now, Rosie, all those tunes you sing wonderfully.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the legendary Iron Butterfly.
Thank you.
Yeah.
We've got a new album we're recording right now in the studio. It's going to be out this summer, hopefully. You might have seen some of the t-shirts say Wings of Flight. Well, here's a song written by Ron Bushy and the rest of the guys in the band here. It's called Don't Hurt the One You Love. for you. I want to say hello up there to KLOS, who's visiting today. You guys are still the greatest. You know, back in 1969, before I was invited to join the band by Ron Bushy and Lee Dorman, I had the pleasure of recording a song for you that we get some requests now and there from people who know about it and stuff, so we'd like to dedicate this next song to all of you. Song I wrote and sang for you back in 69 goes like this. To say we're calling everyone.
Thank you.
founding members, along with Ron Bushy of Iron Butterfly. He's here tonight, coming over to check out the action. He's a retired sea captain right now, but you never can tell about this guy. Say hello to Lee Dorman, ladies and gentlemen. Here's a brand new song we just wrote for the next album, Just Another Lifetime Away.